We are beginning tonight with a couple of sporting events on the Central Coast this weekend.
The first, a half marathon with an Olympic twist. And the second, the cream of the crop when it comes to youth baseball.
Action News reporter Brittany Nielsen is live in our Salinas newsroom with more on both.
All these 11 and 12-year-olds out there playing a lot of good baseball, and they are from across the country and around the world.
It's going to be, like, interesting to play teams from other states and countries across the world.
It's very exciting, very interesting to see kids from Puerto Rico, Mexico, Chinese Taipei. It's some good competition.
Along with teams from New York, Illinois, and around the state, including two Central Coast teams, Monterey and Toro Park.
Awesome. Just very proud of a team.
Ryan Monroe and his team are in Monterey from Adirondack, New York.
We've been working since December indoors, and our goal was to get here into California for the World Series.
We've been on the road since the first week of July. We had to win our states, and then we had to win the Northeast Regionals in New York City. Then we had to go to Pittsburgh and win the East Zone, and then from there, we came right on a plane right out to L.A.
And Monterey locals making the hometown fans proud.
I lived in Monterey almost all my life, and I watched almost all the Bronco World Series, and now he's playing on it, so it's pretty exciting stuff for me. And he gets a chance to represent the whole city, Monterey.
And while families packed the park, so did friends of the 11 and 12-year-olds.
Yeah! Nice play, Batista!
It's really exciting to see the best of the best because there's only a few leagues.
All my friends, they get to play the other teams that are from around the world. And it's a one-time chance for them.
And players know.
Every hit that you get, you'll remember for your lifetime.
And another event this weekend, the Salinas Valley Half Marathon. Runners and walkers got geared up for that today at an expo at Hartnell College. Now, runners got to pick up their bib numbers, t-shirts, and complimentary wine glasses, and check out boots with the latest running apparel, shoes, and health tips. Now, the race kicks off tomorrow at the Soledad Mission, finishes at the Pisano Winery. Now, contestants we talked to today say they have been training for at least months, and they are ready for this course.
Expectation tomorrow is to keep a steady pace, get over those hills, and finish feeling good.
Now, 1,400 runners from as far away as Switzerland, Portugal, and Norway are entered in the half marathon. The youngest is 12, the oldest 83 years old. And while we're talking about some stats like this, the first Salinas Valley Half Marathon winner was Diego Estrada. That was in 2010. He set what is now the race record at 1 hour, 6 minutes, and 29 seconds. And he's now an Olympian. And you're talking about a 5-minute mile there, if you're counting. Tomorrow is the day Estrada will run the 10,000-meter race in London. He's an LSL High grad and will be representing Mexico.
Now he's running in the Olympics tomorrow, so we'll all be sending him great vibes from Salinas. Not only do we have one of our past winners running in the Olympics, but we have a number of elite runners tomorrow who ran in the Olympic marathon trials.
So we have athletes gathering both in Monterey and Salinas, really around the world in London, striving to make a name for themselves with excellence in their fields, whether that be baseball or running. So we have a lot of sports action to keep up on this weekend, guys.
I'm feeling very much like a couch potato. I don't know. Thank you, Brittany.
Thanks, Brittany. A big story of the night. Toro Park came back from a big deficit tonight.
They were actually down by 7 at one point and came back to win their game 10-9 against the team from Puerto Rico. Congrats.